So we've still got a minute to go in this second quarter. And it's a three-point margin, 42-39.
1 minute to go, Rimmer take the lead. They had it by eight.
This at the top is the fan stand.
They
just put it together. Maybe steal back the lead in this half as we approach half-time. Wagstaff, little hook, short. Diamond Simpson up high, can take the boards, but is knocked out by Perth, and the 36ers have a chance to score.
Defense!
Roswell puts it into the front court. The pass down to Simpson. They work up against Wagstaff, just barreling his way through. And a little trouble was called.
I'm
29 seconds remaining. The travel on Simpson and Robbins with a chance to score. Been driving a lot in this game. He goes against the Taunton, and that's terrific stuff from the angry ends.
Going up against two guys at least 6 or 7 inches tall about him. It's a great play.
Clark trying to barge his way through. Just forced it a little bit.
I don't think it was a great option from Mitch Creek, but I think it was a little bit unlucky. Referee probably felt a little bit of a flop there. He was going sideways, and then whoever was playing defense went in the opposite direction, so it's usually a good indication that they've just fallen over by themselves. So.
1 point is the margin. Can the Wildcats take the halftime lead? To higher from outside. It's a hostile environment, and they've certainly come to play. Croswell got plenty of experience to guide his team, and they end their three-game losing drought as Ballinger has it on the wing. Now the way, one-on-one with Redditch, a little jumper, he likes that, and that is a nice play from Stephen Way.
It's a great move. He got caught up in a few of those moves in that first half. It's a great way for Adelaide to come out.
Yeah, Toby being aggressive. Nice little dish off to Redditch. He was blocked twice, Sean Redditch. And Way's quick to get on his skates to Warren. The little fella, can he roll it in? That was an impressive player from Chris Warren.
Great job in transition, Adelaide there. Stevie Way with the no look.
Here's Leach from outside. He needs to hit a basket for confidence. Just off target. Three great games to start the season. Kevin Lish averaging 24 points per game. 28 points against the Crocs last week. Unlucky not to be player of the week in the NBL. Kazoo had a pretty good effort too. As Croswell draws the foul.
Brad Roberts just with Roberts. Hand in there, I think.
Must be. And Croswell will get it on. So 3 points is now the lead to the 36ers. 46-43. Awkward shooting style of Nathan Croswell. Works okay this time. Drops the first.
Perth may be a little bit guilty of coming out in the second half, thinking that just after all that momentum, is Adam Ballinger called for a foul.
He might have
stepped four. Just getting a little bit physical on the block out, I think. The box set down low.
The intention too, hasn't it, to come out and throw your weight around, but he's got four, so they might be looking to sub him out of the game very quickly. It's only early in the third quarter, and their captain is in a bit of foul trouble. Into the front court, Robbins. Pass is good to Matt Knights.
That's a great look from Brad Robbins to Matt Knights, just the zone shifting, opening up the gap there down low.
Was fantastic from Way. He has been terrific, and the little roll from Daniel Johnson was even better. Still a 5-point margin.
The pick and roll's been effective for Adelaide tonight, and they seem to like that. And when they need a basket, Cam Toby stepped up with a big three. The Wildcats in touch, trailing by four. but they have been great on that pick and roll of Adelaide.
Now a 2-point margin, 50 place 48. So Johnson with the inbounds, the pressure will come on Way, and he's unfound there from Rich as the referee. Here's Toby. Rich to the screen on himself. Pass down low. He's not the aggressive. Can he make the basket? No. It won't be counted. It was a nice move as we see the replay. Stephen Way probably slipping in the end, causing the turnover. The ball, a little bit of body contact with Sean Riddich. And Lish kicks that. This play. Riddich to Robbins, posting up on Warren. That's a bad move because he's a big man. Chris Warren. 2 points for Brad Robbins, all tied up again, 50-50.
Not too often Brad Robbins gets the post up as Warren comes back and hits the big three. That's the way to answer when someone takes you down low.
That was brilliant. Here's Lish. The pass was low. And they should score here. Can Diamond Simpson give us something special? Lish will foul.
Chris
Warren,
he stops the 2 point.
Impressive player. And here's the foul Simpson from Lish. Had to make sure he didn't score. But talking about Chris Warren, he's only 22, 23 years of age. Average 9 points for college. University of Mississippi. And Simpson goes to
he struggled from the free throw line tonight. I don't think he's made one.
Warren's been at 42% from the three-point line for this season.
And for two, he'll have one more.
Yes, he'll have one more.
And he doesn't look like getting one. That's not good.
Not impressed with that, Tone.
I'm trying to help him out. Usually the opposite to what I say happens. So.
He's the 40th
but he can do that.
That was superb as Lish couldn't make the rebound. Here's Warren from outside three again. That won't go. Way up high, couldn't take the mark. Couldn't take the rebound. A little bit of footy and basketball joined together. Wildcats ball 53-50. Here's the score, 3 points the lead to the 36ers. Here's Lish outside to Riddich. That one's a little long, the tap down towards Simpson. Warren always keen to get going. Lish had Way covered, but Way will get the shot away. Well played by Kennedy. Desperation at its best. Toby has it. The pass down to Riddich. Now outside to Robbins. He won't shoot from there. He'll want to drive. On Way. Little roll around, doesn't go. And then a physical foul from Matt Knight. Unlucky. Trying to be aggressive.
Yep, I think he was firmly planted. Don't travel.
He slid along the floor, Kevin Lish. It was great desperation, though. No Damien Martin for the first Wildcats. Do you think it's unsettled them at all in this game so far?
Look, obviously last week they went on the road and had a victory without Damien as well. He is a big part of why the Wildcats will be challenging for the championship this year, and they'll want to get him back sooner rather than later. And it can't not have an effect. He's too good a player.
There's another foul. It'll be called on Kevin Lish. A little bit of hip movement from Kevin Lish, just bumping him out the way. Just looking now for Kevin Lish. He's got three fouls. Have to make sure he doesn't get into a bit of trouble. He's got a charge. Matt Knight will sit down as well. And Matt Knight also has three fouls. Here is the foul. Lish just leaning in, wasn't he?
Every time that the Wildcats bring in Luke Neville, Marty Clark counters that and brings in Wade Halliwell. Another body obviously feels he's the best man to match up against Luke Neville.
Luke Neville, I've seen a lot of court time in this game. The big fella, he's only played 6 minutes so far. And their style of play is going to, as I said, take a bit of time.
It's going to take a bit of time.
Isn't it? Let's go. Such big movement. He's struggling on the court at the moment to get there for this passage of play. Good ball movement from the Wildcats. They go to their big man. The pass inside was nice. They just laid off Neville, but it wasn't quick enough as they dropped it into Sean Riddich. Here's Wade. He'll take it up on the big man. And the pass racked it up against the glass for two more. Still 3 points, Adelaide's lead. Lish. Drops one from the three-point arm for Kevin Lish. He's got 10 points. Will that inspire him? One from five from the three-point line, shooting at 20%. Croswell working it into Simpson, and that was a great finish from Diamond Simpson. The points will count. The foul on Williamson. A little block.
Great read by Croswell, though. Just taking the bump, didn't really have anywhere to go, and then just laid it off at the last minute before he was about to travel. And Diamond goes to the line. I don't want to put the mock on him. It's only one, though. He made the basket, so just done for the conversion.
The bonus points for Simpson.
There you go.
Line. That was beautiful, Tony.
That was
Tony.
Perfect. Picture perfect.
How dare you?
Well, sorry, mate. I got a bit confused when the last one hit the backboard first. All right?
3 points, 58.
We've all done it before, though, so.
I'm just going to be on his side because he's big. He is a unit. And I'm only little. This is a foul called on Creek. Lish. Forcing that one. Plenty of fouls being called. They'd be happy with their imports, Adelaide, wouldn't they? They've been impressive to start this game, and also, obviously, the last couple of weeks, they've been some of the better players for the team.
Yeah, I read that Warren was a little bit disappointed with his first game against the Wildcats. He still had 17, and he's been good tonight.
Drew Williamson from outside, drops the frame. That's his first basket of the game. Shooting at 33%, and 20% from the field as well, Drew Williamson. As there's a foul down the other end, Luke Neville called for that one. Just went away from his strengths really last season. Drew Williamson tried to drive a little bit more. Looks to spot up and shoot, doesn't he? Because he's deadly.
Yeah, that's what he does well. That's what he does really well. He's a great shooter when he's left open.
19-17 with the fouls, so pretty even. As Creek goes to the line. He drops the first. One point now, that margin, 5 minutes remaining before three-quarter time. And another one for Mitch Creek. Well, a good little combo. He's a good little athlete.
Correct.
Does look good. Looks like he can shoot the ball as well.
So Kevin Lish running the point now for the